Hello, I'm Maruk Said, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
Human rhinovirus, HRV, is a communicable and contagious virus that causes nasal mucosal irritation, often known as rhinitis. It mostly causes upper respiratory tract infections and derives its name from rhino, which means nose, since it frequently produces a runny nose, nasal congestion, sneezing, sore throat, and cough. There are more than 100 serologic kinds, and all of them can cause the common cold in humans. Rhinovirus is now part of the Picornaviridae virus family. They are naked viruses, roughly 30 nanometers in diameter, and are enveloped by an icosahedral capsid, a spherical protein shell with 20 equilateral triangular faces. And they are naked because the capsid is not protected by a lipid membrane. They are also single-stranded, positive-sense ribonucleic acid, RNA, viruses. This implies that their RNA is mRNA, which the host cell's ribosomes use to produce viral proteins. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Rhinoviruses, unlike other picornaviruses, are acid-labile. Because they may be killed by stomach acid, they seldom infect the GI tract and do not travel from feces to the mouth. Rhinoviruses, on the other hand, are known to infect the respiratory mucosa that borders the nose cavity. As a result, rhinovirus spreads by contact with contaminated respiratory secretions, such as snot and aerosols, particularly those produced by nose blowing or sneezing. Touching an infected surface, such as a door handle or shaking hands, and then touching an uninfected respiratory mucosa is a common route to spread an infection, as rhinoviruses may live up to 2 hours on the skin and 4 days on surfaces. Once rhinovirus enters the respiratory mucosa, it targets cell surface receptors found on nasal epithelial cells. Rhinoviruses may enter cells by targeting a few specific receptors, one of which being intercellular adhesion molecule 1, or ICAM-1. This connection permits rhinovirus to be devoured, or endocytosed, by the host cell. The icosahedral capsid breaks open during endocytosis, allowing rhinovirus's single-stranded RNA to enter the host cell's cytoplasm. Ribosomes in the host cell's cytoplasm take over viral protein synthesis, allowing the virus to proliferate. When a host cell becomes aware that it has been infected, it releases pro-inflammatory proteins such as cytokines and chemokines, which activate and attract immune cells to the site of infection, as well as recruit additional immune cells from blood vessels in the lamina propria, the layer just beneath the epithelium in the respiratory mucosa. And the final effect is localized inflammation. Rhinovirus infections can affect anybody, although certain groups are more vulnerable, such as young children, the elderly, and those who are immunocompromised or have underlying respiratory disorders, such as chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, asthma, or cystic fibrosis. The symptoms of a rhinovirus infection are similar to those of the common cold. Symptoms generally appear 1 to 2 days after infection and remain for around 2 weeks. Typical symptoms include nasal congestion and irritation, which can cause a runny nose, sneezing, headaches, sinus, ear, or face discomfort, and a loss of smell and taste. However, it may also involve weariness, malaise, or loss of appetite, as well as other upper respiratory infection symptoms, such as a painful or irritated throat, cough, or hoarseness. While symptoms are often moderate, variables like as age, immunocompromised conditions, and underlying respiratory disorders can cause far more severe and sometimes even more complicated life-threatening symptoms. Rhinovirus is mostly diagnosed clinically, particularly when common cold symptoms are present without any other problems, worrying physical findings, or relevant medical history. PCR testing of cultures from nasal secretions or washings can provide a conclusive diagnosis, although this is usually reserved for more difficult situations, such as when an individual is immunocompromised or has an underlying respiratory condition. Because rhinovirus infections are usually mild and self-limiting, therapy focuses on alleviating symptoms and preventing others from becoming sick. Common symptom relievers include rest, water, and age-appropriate over-the-counter drugs such as first-generation antihistamines, NSAIDs, and nasal decongestants. To reduce the transmission of the virus, adopt conventional measures such as concealing coughs and sneezes, thoroughly hand washing, especially after nose blowing, and cleaning surfaces on a regular basis. Summary of rhinovirus. Okay, so to recap, rhinovirus, a kind of picornavirus, is the primary cause of the common cold. It infects the respiratory epithelium, usually via the nasal mode of transmission. Rhinitis and other typical cold symptoms, such as runny nose, nasal congestion, and sneezing, are caused by immune cells' inflammatory reaction. A clinical diagnosis is generally made, and treatment focuses on symptom alleviation and preventing the illness from spreading to other people. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon button. Thank you!